Azure Key Vault is used to store secrets. But what if those secrets get in the wrong hands? A threat actor that is doing some malicious activities on your Key Vault. Do you have visibility for that? With Azure Defender for Key Vault, you have the right level of visibility and threat detection for different scenarios. And this is exactly what you're going to see in this episode about Azure Defender for Key Vault. Stay right there, and we'll be right back. Welcome, everyone, to Azure Security Center in the Field, episode 14. Time is going by really fast. And today, we have a very special guest here from our Azure Security Center team / Azure Defender, Walner Dort. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Yuri. Glad to be here.
Thank you very much for taking the time to record this episode, which will be about Azure Defender for Key Vault. Very interesting topic. But before we go to that, can you please give us an overview of what you do for Microsoft?
Yeah, so the team that I'm on is called the Enterprise Protection and Detection Team. So my team primarily builds machine learning detections on top of Azure resources and for different security purposes. And my purpose on this team is to, I'm a feature PM, so I lead different products in terms of, you know, making sure that we're delivering the best customer value and thinking of new different ways to protect our Azure cloud.
And just to clarify, I said Azure Security Center team is almost like a partner of the Azure Security Center team, right? So we consider a whole big family.
Yeah. So we work with Azure Security Center in order to help develop these detections.
That's right. So I was Azure Defender for Key Vault. I was actually looking at some of the alerts that are generated, potentially generated by the Azure Defender for Key Vault. And I noticed that there is one that is called High Volume of Operation in Key Vault. So what really Azure Defender for Key Vault consider a high volume? Because by reading the documentation, it's not really clear on what is a high volume, you know?
Yeah, so we actually train our model using the regular activity from the Key Vaults that we see. So we look at the log data and we determine, the model determines what exactly is considered too much volume, or, and we refer to the past training data in order to see what exactly constitutes, you know, high volume. So it's actually tailored to each tenant.
So that's right, it's tailored to each tenant, which means each customer will have a different perception of what high volume means, right?
Yeah, so the way that we determine how the volume works, we look at the training data for let's say 60 days of activity in order to understand what is normal activity in your environment. And based on that, we'll then be able to decide, like, you know, once we see something that's anomalous, like this is too much volume given, you know, how the Key Vault has been interacting in the past.
Mm-hmm. And this model is something that is out of adjust, or customer needs to do to have any interactions to, you know, like customize or something.
Yeah, so the customer doesn't need to do anything in order for us to learn, you know, what their activity is. Mm-hmm. Key Vaults typically get interacted with, you know, in similar patterns, whether it's by, like, you know, users, applications, service principles, different things like that. So we can learn what is normal, and then we pretty much alert based upon what is anomalous.
Excellent. Good. Since some of these alerts are generated by Azure Key Vault, is based on machine learn. Does it take some time to actually learn more about the environment and then build the models based on this timeline? What is really, you know, the timeline for that, if there is one, and usually how long it takes?
Yeah, so we train our models daily. over 60 days, up to about 60 days of data to understand what exactly is normal activity. So as we train for longer and longer, we build more confidence in the model. So you don't need to have exactly 60 days of data in order for us to start alerting. But as we train more data, the confidence levels of our model increase as we train.
So the likelihood that the customer will receive a high volume alert right after it onboards to Azure Defender for key vault is really low, right? Because the model is not well trained to determine what is high volume.
Yes. It would need to be extremely, there would need to be like an extreme disparity between, you know, the amount of operations or whatever the volume we're seeing in order for us to alert before we have high confidence in what is normal activity.
And I know that, for example, for Azure Store, Azure Defender for storage, Azure Defender for SQL, we do have the capability to enable the Defender piece, the threat detection, only on the resource itself. But for the key vault, it seems like you have to enable on the subscription level, right? Or do you have the option to enable only on the vault?
Yeah, so currently at the time being, we only have the functionality to enable at the subscription level. Mm-hmm. But looking into the future, resource level might be something that we can think about later on.
Great, great, great point. So I'm pretty sure that you have some cool demo to show us today.
Yeah, so I can show you exactly how we fire off one of these alerts and give you an idea of the user experience.
All right, let's do it.
Absolutely. So I've already made a key vault. I've called it the in-the-field demo vault. I just want to go ahead and show you what exactly is looking like in here. So, you know, when you create a key vault, you want to store secrets. I've named this secret here called some type of important secret. If you go inside of it, you know, you'll be able to see that what we're protecting, the secret value, is this is a test, right? So what I have right now is just this key vault here. Let's see, in the security blade, you'll be able to see, you know, we do have Azure Defender for Key Vault turned on this Key Vault. So that lets you know that you're getting the Azure Defender service on this Key Vault. So when anomalous activity occurs, you should be able to see alerts pop up for this Key Vault. Another place where you can check that is if you go into Security Center and then you go here. Here you should be able to see, you know, Key Vault and it's on, for example. So that's different ways you can check to make sure you have Azure Defender enabled. And then I can go ahead and walk through exactly what we're going to do. So the alert that we're going to go ahead and simulate for you today is access from a Tor IP into your Key Vault. So a Tor IP, for those that don't know, is an anonymous IP, and you wouldn't want anybody who's trying to hide themselves looking into your secrets. So that's something that we definitely go ahead and alert on. So in order to simulate that, I'll just log into a VM that I have open just to simulate another computer trying to log in from the Tor IP. And then log into the Tor browser. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to log into the Azure portal. And then I'm going to try to log into my same account that I was showing you earlier where that Key Vault lies. But now I'm accessing it from a different computer and from the Tor browser.
So question on this, as you go through the, do you have to actually access the secret to receive the alert, or just by accessing the portal is already enough?
So we specifically send an alert based upon accessing the vault. So once you access the vault, that's enough for us to trigger an alert.
Okay, so you don't even need to go to the secret. You just need to launch the vault.
Yeah. But things like you know, accessing the secret, those are all information that we do provide in the alert as well. All right, so here goes that same vault that I showed you earlier. Mm-hmm. So I'm just going to go ahead and access this vault.
If you are accessing the vault via API, do you also have the same capability?
Yeah, so we look at all access to the vault. So any anomalous access to the vault will definitely be alerted on. Let's see. So now I'm going to go to my secrets. And also, I'm just going to show you, you know, I'm in the Tor browser now trying to look at these secrets. You know, that's my important secret that I have there. And then, you know, just for kicks, I'm going to go ahead and show the secret value. So, you know, this is a test. So now, after that's completed, that's already, we've done enough activity in order to, you know, trigger an alert. So we actually should be receiving that alert in a couple minutes. But for time's sake, I'm going to go ahead and show you. I did one a little bit earlier today. In the Security Center, you can go ahead and go to Security Alerts right in the overview page. And a little bit earlier, I did this alert right here, which is the same...
Same operation.
Same operation, yep. So then you go in here, and you'll see all the information, right? So it says, you can see on the left-hand side, it gives you a description of what exactly happened with this alert. So it says, you know, a vault has been accessed from a known Tor exit node. This could be an indication of a threat actor has accessed the key vault and is using the Tor network to hide their source location. Mm-hmm. So we give a bunch of different information, you know, application ID, client information, and all these different things in order for you to help do your investigation. It gives you the resource, and then it also gives you some ideas of what you can do in order to take steps to mitigate and remediate this activity. One thing that I also want to highlight is, you know, you're able to leave feedback on each one of the alerts that we send out in this section here, where, you know, we ask, is it useful or not? And that's going to help us know whether or not, you know, what can we do in order to improve these alerts to help them more useful in your use case.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Excellent. Well, this is a very interesting scenario, and I'm sure there are more that we document other alerts. Is that right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So we have a total of 9 alerts currently, all machine learning based. All of them giving you insight into things that would probably be difficult to understand without these alerts in terms of the activity that happens on your key vault.
So we have 9 alerts so far, and we are continuously adding more alerts. Is that correct?
Yeah, so as different use cases come up, we're definitely looking to expand our detection capabilities. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so if a customer has any, you know, specific alert that they'd like to see, or attack vector they'd like to protect themselves from using the Key Vault, that's something that we're definitely open to hearing more about. And we ideate these things as well as we look at some things that, you know, other detection teams are doing. And we, being that, you know, Key Vault is a very important resource, we're definitely looking to continuously add capabilities in protecting our Key Vaults.
Excellent. Walner, it was a great chat. Before we wrap up, do you have any final considerations, recommendations that you want to share with our audience regarding Azure Defender for Key Vault?
Yeah, so I just want to point everyone to the different information that we have available online. So these 9 detections that I spoke about earlier, we have all of these documentation so that you can understand what exactly is going on with these different detections. And there's a lot of different useful information on the Microsoft documentation for our services that give you a broader overview of exactly what's going on with our Azure Defender for Key Vault feature.
Awesome. And I'm also going to share the AKA link here in the bottom for these alerts for Key Vault. So make sure to check it out. And also make sure to try, because it's the free for 30 days, the trial experience. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yeah, so you can do a POC. We also have an article that explains the step-by-step on how to validate the alert. I'm also going to share the link here. So make sure to try and to provide feedback. As Walner said, if you have other scenarios that are not covered, make sure to provide the feedback. Okay. And with that, that's a wrap for episode 14. Thank you very much, Walner, for your participation. I truly appreciate your time.
Absolutely. I'm glad to, you know, teach everybody a little bit more about Azure Defender for Key Vault. Thanks.
Absolutely. Thank you very much for your audience. Keep tuned on Azure Security Center in the field. Subscribe to Microsoft Security Channel so you can receive notifications as new episodes will come up. See you next time.